Shannon Collins. I am a clinical associate professor in the Department of Communication Sciences and Disorders, and this class is Introduction to Communication Sciences and Disorders. Yeah, we have a lot of course objectives. This is a course that really looks at communication across the lifespan, so students have an opportunity to look at communication development and then how we learn speech sounds, how we learn language, how we learn how to implement those skills into reading aspects as well, and then across the lifespan how communication changes and if there is a disruption in that communication. So what kinds of services and support an individual may look to seek out ways to get support for a communication disorder. There's a wide variety of outcomes that students are going to be learning throughout the course, and some of it will be the anatomy and physiology that's associated with communication, speech, language specifically, and looking at disorders of communication, so whether an individual has a head injury or a disease process or maybe born with a communication or potential for a communication disorder because maybe there's a hearing loss. So they look at that those aspects across the lifespan and how communication can be disrupted in some way, and what we would do as speech language pathologists. It looks at the profession of speech language pathology and audiology and how we can support those individuals and families who have a communication disorder. So for that class period, we will be looking at augmentative and alternative communication systems, so ways that individuals that have a communication disorder that's severely impacted and other ways that they may use technology to communicate, or a communication board, and that could be, again, across the lifespan. Somebody could have a communication disorder that's would need an augmentative or alternative communication system early on, or it could be something that happened later in life. So if your grandma has had a stroke and she now has this loss of language, she can use an alternative communication system, whether it's a picture board that she might be pointing to, or a voice output device, so an iPad that has an app on it that allows that individual to use that communication system with voice output. I'm hoping students will take away the fact that communication is sometimes taken for granted, and at any point across the lifespan, your ability to be able to communicate could be impacted. So understanding that there are services and organizations out there that can help those individuals that have a communication disorder, and realizing that communication impacts vocation, education, and social skills. So if you're having difficulties or challenges with communication, like I said, across the lifespan, and knowing that there is a profession out there that can support those individuals, I guess that's my biggest takeaway I hope that the students have, is understanding that we have these services available, and this profession, whether it's audiology or speech language pathology, can support those individuals that have a communication disorder.